what's going on, guys? Prestige here, and today we got a mega update in Call of Duty Advanced Warfare, including a brand new DLC weapon, which I'm using in this gameplay, and a whole bunch of other stuff. So we're going to talk about that throughout this gameplay and get you informed on what you can expect when you log back into Call of Duty Advanced Warfare on your Xbox One or Xbox 360. So without further ado, let's get right into the updates because there are a lot of them. Let's go ahead and start with the one thing everyone always seems to talk about, and that is weapon balancing. What got buffed and what got nerfed? So heavy weapons actually got an entire buff, increasing the player movement speed by 5%, and that was something that I immediately noticed while using this weapon in the specific gameplay. Corrected the scopes on the AE4 so the laser shoots where it should be shooting. MK14 got a reduce in recoil. The ARX got an increased magazine size up to 45 rounds. That is very, very crazy. Extended magazines takes it up past 60 rounds. We got a buff for the AMR9, increased damage and decreased time between bursts, so it's going to cycle a little bit faster every time you pull that trigger. SN6 got a reduce in recoil. The KF5 got a mid damage range increase, and you're going to notice that immediately. The Atlas 45 got a mid damage range increase and max damage range increase. The PDW got increased damage, which is of course another pistol. Shotguns got reduced spread while using Gung Ho. The S12 got an increased fire rate and increased damage. The EPM3 got a reduce in recoil. The Lynx got a reduce in recoil. And the ASM1 got nerfed just a little bit, slightly reduced initial fire rate. And really, it's still a very good weapon to use. So that is everything that happened in balancing as of right now. Heavy weapons are a big priority, it would seem, with that movement speed increase. But the ARX magazine size increase, I'm not sure about that. I thought the ARX, especially the Steel Bite, you're going to see a review on that on my channel very, very soon. I thought it was a very good weapon. The Lynx is very, noticeable with the recoil as well, so I'm actually happy that they did that. Other things that you're going to notice in-game, while opening supply drops, full royalty character gear is unlocked now, so you can find the royalty stuff as you can see here on the screen. Connectivity optimizations, connectivity and matchmaking improvements when in a party, so that's going to help in multiplayer, of course. 15 brand new prestiges were added, the Master Prestige ranks, of course, and Grandmaster Prestige. They added 15 more daily supply drop challenges. I got one of those today, which was get 25 kills with assault rifles in ranked play, which is something that I never play, so that's crazy. It's going to get me to go into that mode. The sound of the SAC-3 with suppressor attachment is actually fixed completely now, so you won't hear it around the map like you could before. There was connectivity improvements to the Xbox Live servers when returning from energy saving mode, which I didn't know that was an issue at all. Added the ability for purchased creative class slots to appear in private matches, which is great. And then another thing you're going to notice is if you have a friend join your party that doesn't have the map pack, it'll actually pop up saying that your friend doesn't have the map pack, so you can't play Havoc DLC and stuff like that. Another thing you're going to notice is there were some score streak updates. So sentry gun turrets now die in one melee hit. Before it took three, now it only takes one, which is very interesting if you ask me. I actually liked how it took three before. I thought, if you earned your sentry gun, it was your sentry gun. It was yours to have. Three hits didn't really seem like much before, but now only one. Going back to old school Call of Duty, and that's what it was before. So that's actually pretty interesting to see. There was a decrease in the amount of time the player has to hold X to exit a remote-controlled sentry turret, which is great because it always gets me killed when I'm trying to, reload my weapon or pick up a care package. I would always accidentally enter my sentry gun, which is just bad. Unmodified missile strikes now travel faster when boosting by hitting the fire button while coming down, of course. And then finally, the Vulcan laser score streak now fires longer. There's been an addition to the ranked play as well, added probation time for players that do not complete or disconnect from ranked play matches. Will properly award division points in the case of forfeited matches or when the other team leaves, of course. So if you play ranked play, don't leave now or you will get probation time. Some other stuff that I noticed that isn't exactly posted on here is the challenge list is actually changed. So it looks a little bit easier on the eyes. The challenges are a little bit better laid out. The camouflage patterns have been fixed as well, so they don't look like that funky red diamond and that funky royalty camouflage. They're actually back to normal and you can see them very, very well. They look great. You also can see that there are new titles that have been added for people that go to Master Prestige, which looks really good. I like all of these. They look great. The background's different. You got the gold emblem on there. Everything looks fantastic. Broadcaster updates as well. Adjusted colors overall for broadcaster mode to make the text and names easier to read and better experience for viewers. Fixed a rare issue where the HUD elements will get stuck in broadcaster screen. Now, there were some map-specific updates as well. Sledgehammer has done some repairs for various out-of-map exploits, meaning if you are one of those players in Infected that like to jump outside the map and cheat your way to victory, you can't do that anymore. Hopefully they fixed them all this time so we don't see anybody go into the same exact spot trying to jump into a vent or jump into a wall or jump into something stupid when you're using a shotgun and you can't kill everybody anyway that way. So I'm really glad that that's fixed. Apparently there was a rare issue where orbital care packages would be removed from areas of the map on drift after the dynamic map event, which is something that I never noticed. There was an A-bomb plant site location that was adjusted for Sideshow, so that's going to be a little bit different now. And then there was a performance issue with the dynamic map pieces on core. I actually never noticed that either, so I'm not sure who was noticing that. Spawn locations on Drift were adjusted as well, so maybe they're going to be a little bit better. I played Drift today and I noticed that they were great. Fixed aerial assault drone and recon drone out-of-world exploits on Sideshow, which is awesome as well. There was also various updates for Exo Zombies. The biggest one was adding that pause button, and various out-of-map exploits were fixed, so you can't really cheat that well on there anymore either if you wanted to get to high rounds or something like that. Honestly, I think some of the biggest things to come out of this update are the fixes to the out-of-map exploits and all of those weapon buffs. We got an MK14 buff, ARX buff, AMR9, which I really want to test, and I'm actually really interested to see how my elite weapons are going to fare now. And then we also have a KF5, SN6, Atlas 45, PDW, shotguns in general, S12, EPM3, Lynx, ASM1 was nerfed, but all the other things before that have had a buff. So we've had basically everything that we thought was weak before a little bit more buffed and a little bit more easier to handle. So with all of this, what are your guys' thoughts on the updates? If you want to check them out for yourself, I will put a link down below in the description so you can check those out. I actually did a complete video on the brand new Ohm DLC2 weapon if you want to check that out as well. You can find a link for that down below in the description as well. But I think that this is a great update, one of the best ones that we've gotten so far. I'm actually really excited to see what Sledgehammer has planned for DLC 2. I know that there's going to be more additions, more exo abilities that are going to be added, and everything of the sort that I'm very, very excited for, and I'm very interested in knowing just exactly what that could quite possibly be. So I will make sure to keep you guys posted. If you would like to, leave a like down below for this information. Do not forget to subscribe for more awesome videos every day, and until next time, everybody, I am out. Peace.